Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, we're going to look at how you can use Dashpivot to perform basic automatic calculations inside of your forms using the formula cell option, which is available for table fields. And this is a really handy feature because it saves time, it eliminates human error, and ensures that all of the data that you're capturing remains accurate. So before we get stuck into how we can set up formulas and what it looks like inside of our forms, there's a few things to note. The first thing is that formula cells can be used in default tables and pre-filled tables, so you can use them in both. The key thing to note is that in a default table, your formulas are going to reference the columns in the table rather than the cells, so that the same formula applies to each row in the table in the same way. So as you add additional rows, the formula executes the same way each time. But in pre-filled tables, formulas can reference any of the cells inside the table. So it means that you can reference not only cells in the same row, but in the same column or completely different columns and rows as well. So just something to keep in mind, and we'll take a look at both during this video. And the formulas can reference number cells, time cells, date cells, other formula cells, and in some rare cases, they can also reference list cells. But this is only for if statements, which we'll cover in part two when we talk about more advanced formulas. And the last thing to note is that Dashpivot formulas use the same operators as Excel. So if you're familiar with Excel and how to write fairly basic formulas, then you're not going to have any trouble picking up Dashpivot and learning how to write formulas in Dashpivot. So let's take a look. In this video, we're going to cover a couple of basic formulas. We're going to look at add, subtract, multiply, and divide, which is our most basic operators. We're going to look at how to calculate a percentage. We're going to look at how to calculate the sum of a set of values and the average of a set of values. We're going to look at how we can do this inside pre-filled tables. The rest, we're going to look at how we can do this using default tables. So let's get stuck into it. What you see here is I've got two screens open. I've got what the formulas look like inside of the forms, and I've also got our template builder open. So we'll be able to take a look at both sort of as we go. And starting from the top, let's look at how we can add two values together. So inside the form, I'm going to populate value, the first value, I'm going to put in a 3, and then a second value, a 4, and you can see that it calculates the total by adding these two values together, and we get the number 7. What's good about the using the formulas in the default table is that the same formula runs for every row that we add. So if we put in 5 and 6, you can see that it calculates 11, and so on and so forth. No matter how many rows we add, it executes the same formula across all of these. In the template builder, what this looks like, you can see here, we have our table, it's called add, which is what we see in the form. We have two columns for numbers that are labeled as value 1 and value 2, and the formula is really quite simple. We have equals, and then we have a set of grid references, which show up in blue when you put your cursor into the formula box here. So we can see A1, B1, and C1, and we're simply just adding A1 and B1 together. So this column plus this column is going to equal what we see in this column here. So that's pretty straightforward. The second one that we have is subtract, and that works pretty much the same way. We can type in a value, 8, and then let's say 5, 8 minus 5 equals 3. And that's because we have a formula here that, again, it just tells us that this column here, A2 minus B2 equals what we see in this column here. Moving on, we have multiply. 3 times 6 is 18. And our formula, we don't actually use an X, we use the asterisk symbol here for multiplication, just like we use in Excel. And you can see that this column equals A3 times B3, these two columns here. So that works really well. And the same for divide. You'll see here, if we type in 15 and 5, 15 divided by 5 is 3. And you can see that here. Division is indicated by using a forward slash. So we have this column here equals A4 divided by B4 to give us our answer. Now, all of this is quite straightforward. These are the most basic operators. Percentage is really an extension of what we used for our divide operator here. All we're doing here is dividing the first value by the second value and then multiplying that by 100 to give us a percentage. So if we have 20 out of 100 is going to give us 20%. Moving on, now we're going to take a look at sum and average. And the way that these have been built in the template builder is by using a pre-filled table. When looking at our table options here, the pre-filled table option is the one that's been selected. And it's a fairly simple one. It only has two columns and it has a few rows. And to demonstrate what it's doing is it's summing up all of the values that we see in these three cells here. So if we type in 3 plus 4, is 7, and then if we populate the last value, plus 5, so 7 plus 5 is 12. And the way that we write this out is a little bit different to the other ones. We have this operator called sum, and so we're saying this cell equals the sum, open bracket, and then we type in the grid references for all the other cells. So we want to add in B6, B7 and B8, and it's going to add up all of those together and give us the sum total, which is what we see here. And last but not least, we're going to run through how we can calculate the average of a set of values. So for example, 12, 14, 16, and it calculates the average of these three values here. And it's quite similar, actually. We are actually just summing up these values and dividing by the number of rows that we have. But Dashpivot does not recognize how many rows there are. We have to hard code that in. So in our formula, it's similar to what we had before. So we're summing up our three cells that we have here, and then we're dividing by the number of rows. And all I did here was count the number of rows that we have, which is 3, and divide by that number, and that's going to give us our average. So that concludes this video. I hope that the information will be useful for you and your team. If you have any questions, you can reach out to us via live chat, both on our website and in the Dashpivot app. And we have a separate video on more advanced formulas if you'd like to learn more about the more advanced options that the formulas can handle. And we have some additional resources contained inside our help article. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.